see. One thing that doesn't surprise them, some they don't say, you get up to the feet, they don't like it either.
Yeah.
Pull some of that paint off a lot. Hey, Bill, at 3:49, they'll let the phone move on camera, but Joey's wife will never sing it. Well, she sung some service, but God down the services sometimes in this song.
Really?
Oh, yeah. I seen her turn many a church service to use this song.
All right, we'll go ahead and get started tonight. Glad to be back. Cold outside and rainy and just everything the pastor said it was this morning, it's still today. But it's still good inside, isn't it?
Right.
Good to be in the family of God. And aren't you glad he's still on the throne? Nothing catches him by surprise. We'll get started. I'm not supposed to see you go ahead and some other prayer tonight.
Our Heavenly Father, we thank you again for this opportunity to be at your house tonight. And God, we just pray of all things, Father, that for a little while we worship you in spirit and truth. Pray, Father, you be in every song sung, and Father, the one may stand for it for the light tonight, that it be a help and encouragement to us. Father, we just pray that we anybody here who don't know you, Father, as a personal Savior, that they can be saved before it's too late. And Father, that one this morning that turns you away, God, we just pray you'll be with them and give them an opportunity, God, before it's too late. We can direct this service in a way that be pleasing to you. Thanks be to Jesus Christ, your holy name. Amen.
Amen. You know, I was almost to the point of saying it this morning, but it was impressed upon my heart this morning that that sign out there, I believe, says worship service in the morning. And I don't know if ours says evening service or prayer meeting in the evening. But you know what? There's a lot of churches that'll just take that right off their sign. Because they're either worshiping or praying.
Yeah.
And I'm thinking, you know, if that's what we meant to do, we most of us got dressed and drove or somehow got here. We're here. We might as well just do it. Amen. But I was thinking about that this morning.
It used to be a little different. They used to pray a couple more times.
Yeah, yeah. I know the meeting I go to down in Georgia, they start as soon as that service is over that year, and they'll meet an hour early on Sunday nights to begin praying for that meeting coming next year. And then during the week, and they have three services a day, every evening they meet an hour ahead of time for that evening service, which is always usually their biggest service. But when you're talking the difference between 650 people, there's not a whole lot of difference between morning service and evening service. But the fact that they still are looking for God to move. And I think the expectations sometimes of God's people just aren't there when they come to church. They're not let down because they weren't expecting anything to happen anyways. I was fully expecting this morning, I was praying, Caleb would come. And I'm still hoping that God's going to use that word. Now, I'm thankful he got to hear what he heard today, both in the Sunday school and in the preaching. You know, and he come willingly knowing. He's got all kinds of schedules now with school and everything. And the wife said, you know, is it really worth it to go get him on a Saturday afternoon and have to take him back Sunday night? It is worth it, you know. And we both realize that because it might be the only preaching he's going to hear this week.
Amen.
And that, with or without him attending that other church, I don't know what they do there. But I don't take for granted just because they're going to a youth meeting or a church service that they're going to hear the preach word of God. And that's just the way it is. So I'm thankful for what we've already seen happen today. You know, he knows the difference. He's learning. He's been around this thing. And he grew up in it. But you know what? It still takes, like Brother Johnson, it takes God to move on his heart. For conviction to be set in, and that seed that's been sown is there, God can work in it.
Yeah.
That's where our confidence has to be tonight. Here we go, I've been away.
Many years I've traveled on this trip, watched the many changes, I've been so low.
Thank you.
created too at the bottom.
When pains of heaven seems on my soul,
taking place. Somebody over here is recovering, somebody over here is healing, somebody over here is hurting, someone over here is wounded, someone else is dealing with forgiveness, and God sends a message and begins to work all of that in the hearts of his people. That's how big a godly God is.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Let's stand, page 149. Thank you.
When the storms of life are raging, stand by me.
Through the sunshine and rain, keeping it so bright.
Anybody else with a song to sing? Mom, you got one?
Ben, I got one.
I wanted to sing this on Sunday morning, but I got God delivered again on my mind, so I got mixed up with the songs.
You may be down, feel that God somehow got to you, that you are faith, the circumstances you can get through. Right now it seems there's no way out, and you're going under. God removes time, time again. Take care of you. You'll do it again. You'll do it again. Just take a look where you are now, where you have been. Have you always come through for you? He's in now.
Thank you.
Somebody made mention of it this evening or maybe this morning that God ain't never surprised by nothing. God can see way down the road and around the corner. He knows the rising up, knows the sitting down. He knows everything. He knows exactly what we're going to face tomorrow. You know how he knows that? He's already been there. Hey, the Bible's turned with me in the Gospel of Luke this evening, 17th chapter. Try not to be long this evening.
Listen.
I believe that blesses the Lord, and I believe that I'm inclined to agree that it puts a smile on his face, Terry, when his people begin to worship him.
Amen.
And when his people begin to seek him the way Abraham did. Mm-hmm. You ever, if you've got children, you'll know exactly what I'm talking about. You'll try to teach your children things and show them things by your own mistakes that you've made in your own life. And as most of our children are today, they know everything and we know nothing. But there comes a time, at least there was in my life, that I realized that Mom and Dad was a whole lot smarter than I give them credit for, Terry.
Yeah.
And I think sometimes the Lord maybe has that same mindset, if you will, when he looks down at his children and sees the shape that some of them are in, wonders why they just don't trust him to take him at his word. And
listen,
everybody that I've read about in the scriptures, Terry, has never, that God told them to go a certain way, God didn't take them halfway out there and leave them to dry.
Mm-hmm.
He went with them all the way.
Amen.
Now, a lot of times it wasn't without problems. It wasn't without trials and storms.
Yes.
But Brother Johnson, he was always with them.
Yes.
And friend, I want to tell you something tonight. As a child of God, we've got that same promise tonight.
Amen.
We've got the Lord that's going to be on our side until He calls us home, Brother Johnson. He's going to be with us.
Yes, sir.
If we'll look to Him,
yes,
seek His face, He'll be with us. You know how I know that? Because His Word promises us that. And the Scripture says, I believe in Proverbs, Terry, that He's not slack concerning His promises. I may promise you something and let you down by my own ignorance or what have you, but when God promises you something, friend, you can take it to the bank, Terry. It's going to happen. It may not happen when you want it to or I want it to, but it will happen eventually.
Amen.
But let's read here and see what the Lord's got in store for us tonight. 17th chapter of the Gospel of Luke, beginning in verse 11. It said, and it came to pass as He went to Jerusalem that He passed through the midst of Samaria and Galilee. And as He entered into a certain village, there met Him ten men that were lepers, which stood afar off. They lifted up their voices and said, Jesus, Master, have mercy on us. When He saw them, He said unto them, go show yourselves unto the priest. And it came to pass that as they went, they were cleansed. And one of them, when he saw that he was healed, turned back with a loud voice, glorified God, and fell down on his face at His feet, giving Him thanks, and he was a Samaritan. Mm-hmm. Jesus answering said, were there not 10 cleansed, but where are the 9? There are not found, they return to give glory to God, save the stranger. And He said unto him, arise, go thy way, thy faith hath made thee whole. And that's all we're going to read tonight and pray for.
Listen.
For just a few minutes here. And I was thinking a little bit about this passage of Scripture this afternoon and thinking about how good God is and what all God has done for us. And I thought about these 10 lepers there as they came that way and they looked at Jesus, Brother Johnson, and they said, have mercy upon us. Amen. You see, if you was a leper in Bible days, Terry, you had no dealings with society.
Amen.
You wasn't allowed around any of them. Amen. But isn't it amazing how even a leper could have, amen, could come so close, and when they would even have an encounter with Christ, it didn't bother that leprosy one bit, that God was able to do all things. Amen. But I got to think a little bit about these 10 lepers and how they stood afar off. They said, Lord, have mercy upon us. And Christ told them exactly what they needed to do. Amen. He said, go show thyself, amen, to the priest. And I've often wondered how many times that we found ourselves in similar situations in life where we're troubled or have sickness come about us or a trouble or a trial. And we'll go to the Lord and the Lord will tell us exactly what to do, Brother Terry, and we will not listen to the Lord, amen, and we find ourselves in trouble after trouble after trouble, but when we go back and do what God told us to do, then, amen, that things are a whole lot better off,
amen,
amen, for us, if we'll look at Him, amen. I'm glad to know tonight that Christ is not just some fairy tale, that He's not just some elf on a shelf sitting there, if you will, that some imaginary figure. Yeah. But listen, church, He loved the portals of glory, Terry. Yeah. Amen. For your sin and my sin. He's making intercession right now on the throne of grace right now, looking down on us at whatever we need here tonight. Amen. November the 12th on a Sunday night. Amen. He's looking down at our every need tonight. Wanting to help us with, amen, whatever our need is tonight. And, preacher, how do you know that tonight? He's standing waiting, amen, for us tonight. I believe that, amen, that it blesses God to be able to help His children tonight. I believe it blesses Him, amen, Brother Terry, to be able, amen, to work over the times you've kneeled down. And the times you have prayed, amen, on your grandson's behalf. Brother, I know beyond a shadow of a doubt, there's going to come a day, amen, Lord, have mercy. You're going to see that prayer answered. Preacher, how do you know
empowering.
We need to thank God for what he does. And most of all, for what he ain't done yet. Our preacher, what he has done. We have faith. Like the days of old. God will move.
Amen. Thank you, Lord.
Hear these 10 wives. They came out there. They said, go show yourself to the priest. And so
thank you, Lord.
And they did. And the Bible says that only one of them lepers returned back to give God the glory. Amen. And give him thanks. Amen. Yes, he did.
Yes.
Christ asked him, he said, where? Are the other nine? He said, was there not 10 of you?
Yeah.
He said, where are the other nine? Amen. And the one told him. See, the one leper that was healed, he wasn't even a Jew.
Yeah.
He was a Samaritan, brother.
Yes, amen.
Amen. But you know what he done? He got down on his hands, his knees, and he thanked God for everything that God had done for him and touched his life. Amen. How many times, amen, do we sit there? And I'm the world's worst. But Dixie, have a pity party for ourselves. Nobody shows up but ourselves. When what we ought to be doing is saying, thank you, Lord. A Rockefeller mansion, but it keeps me warm. Thank you, God, for everything that you've done for me. Amen. Listen to me, church. He's worthy tonight to be praised. He's worthy tonight for us to thank him.
Yes,
is there anybody here tonight to thank him tonight, church? We've got a reason to praise him.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Lord.
The rest of the world is foolish
and
crazy. Amen. But we've got a reason
to thank him.
Amen. Somebody asked me here a while back.
Amen.
Amen. Going through some struggles and trials in life. Somebody asked me how I was doing. Amen. I told them. So I'm hanging by three. Amen. You give me the best advice anybody could ever give me. Good old preacher friend of mine, he said, you're hanging by a thread. I said, yeah, I am. He said, you know what you need to do? I said, what's that? He said, tie it in a knot and keep hanging on. Amen. God will be with us.
Amen. Yes, amen.
Even when we're ready, amen, to throw the towel in and give up, say, what's the use? All God is wanting tonight is for a few people to worship him and thank him tonight for what he's done for us. Amen.
Amen.
He said, was there not nine? He said, yeah. Amen. There are not found that return to give glory to God save this one stranger.
Amen.
And Christ said to him, arise, go thy way, thy faith made thee whole. Amen. How many times have we been found that I was this way? I was this way times in my life. I'd say, God, if you help me with this, and then, Lord, I'll do this for you, never do that. And especially, I was real bad for it. My brother Terry, when I was out in the world, carrying on drinking, you know how all that goes. Not proud of that. Amen. Amen. Be praying to the poor thing, God. I said, sick, you can't see straight. Lord, I'll never do it again if you help me. Next week it rolls around. Oh, what did you go back to do? The same thing. Aren't you glad, Terry, God took that from you? Aren't you glad tonight? Amen. He put something different. I want you in your heart. Amen. And then we've got a reason to thank him for. Amen. Listen, I do. Terry, listen to me a million days. I should have been dead and gone. But for the grace of God, he brought us through it. We got a reason to thank God tonight.
Amen.
He said, where's the other nine? He said, I don't know. But that one Samaritan returned, and he gave God thanks for what he'd done for him. Amen. You go back and you read the scripture about the woman with the issue of blood.
Yes, amen.
It's recorded in Luke, I believe, about the 8th chapter. Amen. Y'all know the story well. Amen. She said, if I could touch the hem of his garment, I know I could be made whole. Spend everything she had, spend every dime of it. She got in the crowd, I believe she pressed through the crowd, and she touched the hem of his garment.
Amen.
Jesus turned to his disciples and said, "Who touched me?" Yeah. "Who touched me?" And they said, "You're crazy, Lord. All this multitude here, and you want to know who touched you?" He said, "Listen, boys, I feel virtue leave my body."
Amen.
"Somebody has touched me."
Amen.
Amen. The disciples probably looked and said, "Lord, you're crazy. But you know what? Last time I checked, I'm not a woman, and I don't know how to sew." Amen. "But last time I checked, you put the hem down here, don't you?" "You know." Amen. "So that tells me she had to be on her hands and knees." Amen.
Yes,
"When she touched his garment." Preacher, what are you getting at? I believe when she touched him, I believe right then, she felt that issue of blood withdrawn from her. And she was in the position to thank.
Amen.
Where was she at? At his feet. Where we belong. Well, let's thank him tonight.
Amen.
God's been good to us.
Yes.
We got a reason.
Yes, amen. Glory.
We're not going to hell. He's been good.
Woo!
We ought to thank him.
Well, glory.
Amen. We ought to worship him.
Yeah.
Bless him. Amen. Thank you. One even better than that. Amen. Even Jesus thanked his Father.
Yeah.
Amen. When he had the multitude there.
Yeah.
And he got
well,
the bread out.
Glory.
He gave thanks.
Yeah.
He said, "Father, thank you."
Yeah.
Hey, if Jesus can thank his Father,
yeah,
then so
glory.
Tonight. Amen. God is worthy.
Yes, he is.
To be praised tonight, church.
Amen.
He is so worthy to be praised and honored.
Amen.
And worshiped tonight. Amen.
Amen.
I'm so glad.
Thank you.
So glad of what God has brought me out of. Amen.
Amen.
And I'm so glad for what God has done for me in my life. Amen. Amen. Give me the best woman. Heather says all the time.
Amen.
Every time I preach about her, it's something bad. Amen. I'm going to give me the best woman.
Bless
amen.
Lord.
A preacher could ever ask
bless
for.
Lord.
Amen. Stood by me through thick and thin. And above that, saved all three of my children.
Amen.
And I love the Lord.
Amen.
I ain't afraid to talk about him and worship him. That's enough, Terry, if you never bless me again.
Yeah.
Amen. To thank him.
Yes. Amen.
For what he's done.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. The other night, we did not return. Listen to me now, church. Everybody else may not return and give God thanks. Thank the few faithful ones that can give him. Amen. As Joshua said, "As for me and my house, we're going to serve the Lord tonight."
Yes.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Well, glory.
We got something to thank him for. Amen.
Amen.
I can't speak for nobody but me.
Bless the Lord.
But he's been good to this Lord.
Yes.
Preacher, you have troubles. Amen. Follow me around. I'll have a few more this week. I'll
bless the Lord.
Amen. But one thing about it. Amen. Brother Johnson, every trial I've started through, he's been right there beside me.
Amen. Thank you, Lord.
I didn't know how he's going to climb
the
mountain.
Thank you, Lord.
What do you do?
Bless the Lord.
He'd say, "Grab on, son."
Yeah.
Amen. "Lord, ain't you going to move this mountain out of the way?" No.
Bless the Lord.
But I'm going to help
thank
you.
Thank you, Lord, Jesus.
Amen. And with his grace,
yes,
yes,
and his strength,
yes,
he helps us climb
amen
those mountains. Amen.
Well, tell you something, Lord,
right, church.
We've
got a reason
Lord
to thank him.
Yeah.
Got a reason to praise him. Amen.
Yes.
Even when it seems like
oh,
nobody
yeah
cares. Amen.
Bless the Lord.
You know what? It tickled my heart this morning.
Bless the Lord.
Amen. They didn't expect to see Caleb here.
Yeah.
But it tickled my heart when I seen him.
Yeah.
I said, "Thank you, Lord."
Yeah.
At least I know one more Sunday morning he'll get a chance to hear the gospel.
Yeah.
The choice is up to him what he
amen
does with it, though.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
We've got a reason.
Amen.
If we'll keep doing what God wants us to do and thanking him and praising him
yes
and serving him, he'll keep bringing the lost
amen
in. I'll assure you of that.
Amen.
Amen. I like what Terry said. Amen. Amen. That sign out there says 11 a.m. worship.
Yeah.
I ought to say Sunday evening worship.
Amen.
I ought to say during the week worship.
Yeah.
Amen. Because every time we come to the house of God,
amen,
we ought to be able to worship.
Yes.
Him.
Amen.
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 Yeah.
And spirit.
In truth.
And in truth. Nine of them did not return.
Yeah.
And give God praise that he so rightly deserved.
Bless the Lord.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
I used to sing an old song when I was a kid growing up on Kentucky Park. Amen. I said, "Lord, I didn't come to ask you for anything.
Amen.
Amen. I just came to talk
Amen.
With you, Lord.
God bless you.
Amen. You've answered a million prayers, Lord. Amen. Brother Johnson, you ever answered a prayer for you? Amen. Dixie's yeah. answered a prayer for his sins. Amen. He's answered a bunch for me, too.
Oh, yeah.
Amen.
And
before
Lord.
But as I told you this morning, just like I told you this morning, by the
Thank
time
you,
we get out these doors, get in our cars and go home or go to work, whatever we want to do, amen.
Thank you, Lord.
No devil's going to come along and he's going to say, you're crazy for believing that. You're crazy for thinking that. Amen. Listen
hey,
to me tonight.
Thank you, Lord.
As the brother said, the only thing Satan has to throw at us is the gate.
Yes.
You know that? Because when Christ defeated death, hell, and grave and came out of the tomb, what did he tell him? He told Peter, he said, upon this rock I will build my church and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. That's all the devil's got.
Amen.
Amen. There's a bunch of lies in the gate.
Yeah.
He knows he's on borrowed time.
Amen.
Amen. He couldn't get the Savior on the mountain to bow down and worship him. And when Satan was defeated at Calvary, and Christ rose the third day.
Amen.
One of these days, Terry, amen.
Amen.
Satan's going to be put in his place
yes.
forever.
Amen.
Amen. Preach so much to God for so much he's already done.
Thank you, Lord.
In this life. But most importantly, one day after a while, if we go by the way of the grave, amen. Which, no matter which one we go. Brother Terry, when you lay this whole jar of clay down, you know what? He's not going to leave you right there. Brother, I believe with my whole heart. When you take your last breath and I take my last breath, he's going to be right there. When you close your eyes, I'm going to grab you by the hand.
Yeah,
say,
glory!
Oh, let me show you all that I
Well, glory.
Then we're going to have a reason. Or to thank him up there, too. Only one return. Give God praise.
Thank you, Lord.
Thanks. Church, we got to thank him through the hard times.
Bless you, Lord.
We got to praise him through the rough times.
Amen.
It's easy to praise him, Dixie, when you're on top of the mountain.
Yeah.
And everything in life is going good. But you know what? When you're going through that little valley, that you're having trouble making one step at a time, the more you praise him in the valley,
yes.
I'm
going
to miss out. Amen. Yeah. Stronger you're going to be when you come out the other
Amen.
End.
Yeah.
Amen. We've got a reason tonight
Amen.
To thank God for what
yes,
he has
amen.
Done.
Amen.
Amen. Does anybody know that song tonight I was just talking about? I just came to talk with you, Lord. If anybody knows, I'd love you to come sing. If you
Amen.
Don't, that's all right. Amen. Listen to me tonight. God is worthy to be worshipped and praised and thanked tonight. Amen.
Amen.
For everything he's done. Amen. For us in our lives tonight. We've got a reason to thank him.
Yes.
At least I do. I can't speak for you. I do. Amen. We need to thank him and we need to praise him.
Yes.
And above all that, for what he's going to do. Amen.
Yes. Amen.
I believe God's got some good things in store for the church. I believe
Amen.
That. My whole heart. I believe that. Amen.
Amen.
I long for the day, Terry, and I believe in my whole heart.
Bless you, Lord.
Call me a fool. Amen. I long for the day. Amen. That we see Caleb come give his
Amen.
Heart to God. I long for the day to see when Dixie's
yeah.
children come. Amen. To see them come to God.
Yeah.
I love nothing better. Amen. For that. Amen. And your other people's
Amen.
Children and grandchildren. Preacher, can that happen? Yes, it can.
Amen. Yeah.
If we just ask God,
That's cool.
God will do those things, church. Amen. If we'll pray and ask Him.
Yes.
You believe that?
Yes. Amen.
You believe that?
Amen.
God can do the impossible this morning,
Amen.
This evening. Amen. Stand on your feet tonight.
Amen.
Come get your song. Just worship Him. Just worship Him. That's all God wants from us, is to worship Him and thank Him for what He's done. So many times when we find ourselves, at least me, God will do something in our life, and I forget to thank Him for what He did. Amen. We forgot to thank Him for everything He's done.
Amen.
And we take for granted so much what God does for us. Amen. We forget to thank Him. But then we go on about our business, Brother Phil, and then God does something else for us.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
God bless you.
Amen. Sometimes, you ever just been sitting there driving down the road or whatever, and the Lord would move and you'd see something, and there was no doubt in your mind that it was God.
Amen.
And Terry, you'd have to say, God, I know that was you.
Yeah. Amen.
Thank you, Lord, for that.
Yeah.
Amen. God is good tonight, church.
Amen.
He is good, and we need to thank Him for all that He's done. As they sang tonight, how about you just worship Him for a little while? Worship Him for a little bit, amen. As they sang. Listen to the words. When was the last time you got down on your knees and just had a good old fashioned talk with the Lord? Say, Lord, I didn't come here tonight to ask you for anything. Just came to talk with you. How about it?
He wasn't looking for information, but he wanted us to see what was going on. Yeah. This is like when he asked the disciples, you know, will you also go away? You know, he knew who would betray him from the beginning. I guess probably the thought with them was, how could it even be possible that you could walk away from such love and truth and grace? Because that's what he was. But many of them did. And what he said didn't fit their agenda. But I'm thankful by his grace, 30-some years later, to be in a little church on a Sunday night in November. Thank God for his goodness and his grace. And that doesn't mean the devil ain't going to try and throw everything he can at me, and who knows what will happen next week. But I think God is able to get us through that. But I thought about that when you said, where are the other nine? And I know some that have, just flat out denied God, denied everything they knew.
Yeah.
And it's just really sad.